Hi everybody, it's Saturday. Okay, I'm pretty tired today, so give me a second. So yesterday, I don't know if I tell you that there's a woman on the third floor who we've kind of become little friends in the building, and so she has a 6-year-old daughter, and yesterday I was going to the store and this poor little kid was playing outside all by herself, playing hopscotch. And so as soon as she saw my daughter, she's like, "Oh, where are you guys going? Can I go to the store with you? And when are you coming back?" So I told the little girl, I said, "Listen, when we come back, my daughter can play with you for a little bit before her bedtime." So I went to the store, I think I went to get wine or something. And then I decided to get like some chips and juices for the kids. And I came back. So the little girl was just ecstatic that that my daughter was there. They were playing outside for like 5 minutes, but I don't really like outside playing at night, especially, and in front of that street, it's like a busy street on the weekends because I live across the street from a church, and they're always fighting for parking spaces. Like I have to have my car sitting still from Friday through Sunday because if not, I don't have parking space at all. I come back from anywhere busy, full of bags, and I can't find any parking space, and I have to park like super, super far away, and I hate it. So there's a lot of traffic on the weekends here. A lot of people I don't know, especially older people, don't know how to drive, and then they're trying to parallel park in these little spaces that they don't fit. And one of them kids is gonna become a pancake. So I decided to tell the kids to come inside the house and play. So my daughter loved the idea of having this little girl over. The little girl's very sweet. You can tell a lot about a kid's parents by the way they act. So, while she's very sweet and all, Kitty, please don't jump there. That's where the camera is. Come. Kitty's like, "I'm not going anywhere near that cigarette." Come. Just a second. She's trying to jump. This is the cat who I just got spayed. Let me try to show her to you. Hey, you. Okay, she's ignoring me. And the other cat is dying just to get out the house. Okay, so anyways, I'm sorry for the interruption. So yeah, my kid was really happy. This little girl's very sweet, but this little girl's also got some little quirks. I'll tell you about that in just a second. The quirks weren't so visible last night. Boy, were they visible today. So at 10 o'clock, I'm kicking this kid out because I want to work out. And I usually work out right before bed because I'm already like really amped and I'm not going to sleep in the night. So the girl leaves. The mom comes down, obviously. I give the mom my phone number. "Listen, whenever your kid wants to play and stuff, it's okay. Just call me first. And if I'm available, she could come down here or I could send my kid up there because I know her and, you know, she doesn't live with any guy or anything. So it's okay." This morning, I thought I was gonna sleep in today. Nope. This morning, this little girl and her mother come knocking on my door super early. And my daughter was already ready with shoes and her little bag packed with toys and everything. And she leaves. She goes upstairs for about half an hour. Then the plan was for this kid, for my daughter to be in their house today. Like, go make the mess up there somewhere else today. I clean my house so good. I have to disinfect my house now with bleach when I mop because the cat, I told you guys, my cat has cystitis, so she can't control her bladder. Sometimes she doesn't make it to the litter box. So she's having a lot more accidents. And this is the part where if I was a piece of shit animal lover or so-called animal lover, the cat is dying to get out. This is the part where I would probably turn the cat in to the shelter or give the cat away, but I'm not gonna do that. I understand that my cat is sick and I can't help her right now, but I can tolerate her little accidents. I mean, I can just clean it up. There's not a problem. So I cleaned my house really well. I got the cat pee smell out of here. And then my daughter came down with the little kid. Oh boy, this little kid. They turned the room upside down that I just cleaned. I don't mind the toys. What I do mind is that, you know, when I was little, I used to love Play-Doh. But I used to play with Play-Doh differently. Or maybe, I don't know. Maybe I'm thinking a little bit differently. But this little girl got Play-Doh and did everything with the Play-Doh. I have Play-Doh everywhere in my house. And Play-Doh, I don't know, it's fun to play with and all, but boy, is it a fucking bitch to get out of the rug. The Play-Doh is embedded in the rugs, and I'm gonna get every single thing of Play-Doh I find in my house and throw it in the garbage or hide it when this kid comes. But yeah, so this little kid is playing with my daughter. They're having a great old time. And then this little girl starts getting weird on me. She starts dancing in the mirror, right? Which is fine, except she's dancing like booty dances, you know? Like she's like pop that coochie kind of dance, you know, Doodle Brown and all that shit in front of the mirror. Okay, I don't want my daughter to dance like that, okay? There's no pop that coochie dance in my house, okay? Not unless there's a few bottles of wine first, okay? So, but anyways, yeah, this little kid was dancing Pop That Coochie and Doodle Brown to herself. And then this little girl wanted to play games where, like, they were making out or something, but not making out with my kid. As soon as I heard that whole making out bit, I was on top of their ass like a hawk to make sure no little playing doctor and all that occurs. Because, you know, kids at that age, they kind of see what other people do and they want to do it. So, they went from playing Barbies 1 minute to freaking talking about making out and all this stuff. And I was like, whoa. So after this kid, I had to kind of slow down their gameplay a little bit. And my ex just called and he's like, listen, I got out of work early. I want a drink. Do you think about, can I go over there, have a drink with you? And but I work tomorrow. I think he was thinking that he was gonna drink and then sleep in my house and bunk in my bed. But I told him no, that I was not gonna drink. Although I am, but I'm not gonna drink with him. So he comes, right? I tell the little girl to go because her dad's coming. Little girl's like, see you tomorrow. Yes, but not too early, please. I wanna sleep in. So my ex comes now. He's like, oh, can I borrow some money? You wanna borrow money from me? The woman who's not working now? Jesus. Oh, because I want to get you a bottle of wine and I want to get me a bottle of whiskey. No. You sure you don't want to have a drink? I'm like, no, I have to work out. Oh, we could drink after you work out. I was like, no, I'm tired. I've been all day, you know, with the kids, which is true. And I don't want to have a drink. He's like, well, did you cook? Can I eat? Oh, God. I didn't cook, thank God. I was this close to cooking, but I didn't cook. Somebody told me don't cook. And a good thing, too. And so he left. He took my daughter for the night. She's gonna spend the night over there just for today. And then he's gonna bring her back tomorrow at 11. And then he'll get her at night till Wednesday. So, but yeah, this guy. So, anyways, my back is very itchy because the sunburn is peeling. I went to the store and the cashier's like, oh my God, what happened to you? I think she thought like I got burned in a fire or something because it looks really bad back there. So I had to tell her, no, I'm not a fire burn victim. I'm actually just burned by the sun. My skin is itching, my goodness. I am my own entertainment because I've been peeling the skin off. It's just gross, but so yeah. My night, thank God I have a free night now. I want to write tonight. I want to drink. I'm gonna read now a little bit. I was reading all day yesterday before that whole kid fiasco. I've been reading by Lionel Shriver. Let's talk about Kevin. Oh my God, if you haven't read this book, please read this book. This book is about this mom who has this little kid, and from the womb, this kid is evil. I'm telling you, this kid is just straight up badass. Before his 16th birthday, he kills seven classmates. I think it's seven or nine classmates, and his father and his little sister. But he doesn't kill his mom. You have to kind of. It's like a. I won't say a love-hate relationship, but I believe that he loves her because he left her alive. Either that, or he just wants to torture her, and you know. So. But it's a good book. It's basically the whole relationship with those two, how she doesn't love him because she knows that he's kind of like he's just evil. This kid just does all kind of bad things that you question if this kid is demonic or what. But she doesn't ever say I don't love you or I hate you, anything like that, even though he's telling her constantly and all this stuff. But it's just a very interesting read. I read the beginning, I've never read the ending of it, I've never gone to the middle and the ending, so I actually found this book the other day and I'm like, oh my god, it's a sign, I want to read this. So I've been glued to the book. I'm gonna read a little bit, hopefully. I need to work out, but if this book consumes me like it did the other day, I won't be able to work out. But I'm gonna work out, and then I'm gonna have a drink and write tonight, and hopefully sleep well, because I have no kids in my house, and no ex that's gonna be calling me, and nobody's gonna be bothering me. So, and I can sleep tomorrow in a little bit, which I desperately need. Yesterday I did not binge purge, because the kids were here. The kids were here all day too, so I didn't binge purge, but I did eat today. I feel sick now. I feel really, like, I have bad indigestion. My stomach sounds like freaking monsters in my belly. It's just like all kind of noises coming out of there. And that's my stomach basically not knowing what the hell to do with the food. So it's really challenging to eat when I do decide to eat. But yeah, I ate today a little bit. I'm not gonna, I know tomorrow I'm probably gonna panic about my weight, but I don't know. I'm trying to not panic so much, you know. It's hard though, it is. It's really hard to not worry about food, you know, not worry about eating and the gain and all that shit that comes with it, but I'm trying. So I think that is all. I'm going to go ahead and get started. I need to work out now. If I don't work out now, I'm not gonna do it later. I'm just gonna start reading and then start drinking and then forget about that. Yeah, so that's it. I hope you're all enjoying your Saturday. We'll talk again tomorrow. And that's it. So goodbye, everybody.